Since we're talking about stoichiometry, it becomes important to plan some type of attack when it comes to any type of stoichiometric question. To do this and to help us, we're going to use this stoichiometric chart. Now, what we should realize is the stoichiometric chart is broken up into two basic types. We have our given information, and that'll be information they tell you in the very beginning of the chemical equation, chemical question. And we're going to say that the given information will be in grams, moles, or maybe entities. When I say entities, entities means atoms, molecules, or particles. Now, the other part of the stoichiometric chart deals with unknown information, basically what we're asked to find. And we're going to say this unknown information could be asked to, we could be asked to find moles, grams, or entities. Now, the way this works is our main goal is to go from moles of given and jump over to our unknown information. So as we're making the transition from moles of given to moles of unknown, we're basically taking a leap of faith because we're going from an area where we know information to an area where we know nothing at all. So we're going to say that this transition is called the jump. So as we go from moles of given to moles of unknown, that's our jump. We're going to say when we make this transition, we have to do what's called a mole-to-mole comparison. Now what that means is that means that we have to use the coefficients in the balanced equation. So this is basically the only time we're going to look at the coefficients in our balanced equation. So use the coefficients in the balanced equation. Okay. Now, when do we use this chart? We use this chart anytime they give us a chemical equation, a balanced chemical equation, with the known quantity of a compound or element, and they ask us to find the unknown quantity of another compound or element.